In this training, we're going to talk about how to create a new account in your chart of accounts. All right, so I'm going to go into my chart of accounts here. You can see that the chart of accounts is all your different accounts that go into your business. All right, it's not your items that you use, your items that you sell. It's not the services that you produce, services that you purchase. These are your accounts that make up your profit and loss statement and your balance sheet. Okay. You have your bank accounts, accounts receivable, other current assets, all these different account types, and you can see them here. But how do I create a new one? You come down here under new account, or you can push Control N. All right, and you choose which account type do you want to create. Is it an income or expense account? Is it a fixed asset account? Notice also that when you click on each of these different buttons, they give you a little summary over here. So what is income? Categorizes money earned. What is a loan? Tracks the principal your business owes for a loan or line of credit. Then there are also other account types. Some people forget that these are hidden under here. So you have an other asset. Again, it gives you some examples of other assets. And other income gives you some examples. But we're just going to go ahead and create a new bank account. Okay. So I'm going to say continue here. Again, I do have the option to change if it's a bank account, asset account, income account. So I do have an option to go back and change this if I want to. So I'm going to go ahead and say payroll checking. If it's a sub account, and in another video we talk about headers and sub accounts. So this is a sub account of cash and cash equivalents, okay, because it is one of the items that are one of the accounts that I want to roll up the balance into cash and cash equivalents. You can put in here a description. Most of the time people use the same description as the account name. It's not a necessary field either. If you are going to do some online banking connecting with, you can put in here account number, your routing number. Again, this is optional. Then you choose your tax line mapping. What this means is if you use QuickBooks to connect directly to TurboTax, it's going to pull out, oh, cash, this account is a cash account, and which account it should go to on your tax return, which line. If you want to enter your opening balance, you can do that here. I prefer not to enter my opening balance through this way. I prefer to enter it directly in the bank statement and record all, the bank register and record all of the transactions that happen in the bank. If you want to have a reminder when to order checks, so let's say once you get to check 500, it's time to order, so it'll give you a reminder. And I also, if you want to order checks from QuickBooks, it gives you that option. But let's say we don't want to have this kind of account. We're going to switch it over to an expense account. Different fields come up here, okay? So I'm going to say payroll expenses instead. All right? Again, it's a sub-account. Now it can't be a sub-account of cash and cash equivalents because that's a bank account, so I have to choose a sub-account of something else. All right, I'm going to copy that name, put in the description. Any special notes here? Now my tax line mapping, I have to decide which tax line it should be associated with, and we'll go down here to, let's see, does it have payroll? Can't see it right away, compensation. So let's put it there. And if it's tracking, it's the ability to track reimbursed expenses, and you can choose that here and put it against, you know, the income side of it against a different income account. Okay, where that's helpful is if this was a direct expense or a cost of goods sold, you can track it on the income and expense side of things. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and say save and close, and then we have that new account on our chart of accounts.